Hey guys, welcome back to Learn and Trade Forex, your go-to channel for everything when it comes to trading Forex. I want to go over this Euro Swiss Franc trade that we took on last week that was really successful. It was a great setup at a level of monthly support. I want to show you guys the top-down approach, how I walk through the trade, and also why the daily candle is so important when it comes to trading, right? This daily candle can give you, can let you know what the market is about to do. We base it off momentum. It can give you direction for long-term trades. It can give you direction for short-term trades and also counter-trend trades, which this trade was an excellent counter-trend trade. So let me walk you guys down that top-down approach to this trade. I'm gonna show you guys exactly what I was looking for. And then at the end of this video, I'm gonna attach another video so you guys can see the trade perform. Okay, so let's go. So as you guys already know, my top-down approach starts on the monthly time frame. With every trade that I take, I start on the monthly time frame. Reason why I start on the monthly time frame, because before I make a trading decision, I need to know what's the overall trend of the market and what the market is currently doing. So now we see the market is going down. It has just broken this level right here of support to the downside. Now, once the market breaks a support or resistance level, we know the market has a tendency to want to come back and test that level. So I noticed that earlier in the month, I took the trade on the second week in the month, but earlier in the month, the first week of the month, price started to reverse. So let's read the market together, guys. This is December. Price came all the way down in December. It came down to here. Buyers stepped in here and pushed the price up a little bit. That's why you have this wick. This wick represents buyers stepping in and pushing the price up somewhat. Now, they didn't push the price higher than where the price started, so the candle still closed bearish. Okay, now January comes in. I noticed the market opened in January here. Price went down again. Buyer stepped in and pushed it higher. As a matter of fact, when you go down to the weekly time frame, you will see that the first week in January, price pushed up higher and it closed bullish for the first week in January. Okay? So we know we have a resistance level, a support level right here. Okay. So now my mindset after looking at the monthly time frame is price came down so far and now it's beginning to push up. So let's go to the weekly. Also, remember that the overall trend is down, so this is going to be a counter trend trade if we even get into a trade. Okay, so this is the last week of December. First week in January, price opened up, pushed down, it found buyers, so price headed back to the upside. Okay, so this is where I come in. Price looks like it wants to go up, but I also got to remember that price went up here, but sellers stepped in here and pushed it down. Sellers stepped in here and pushed it down at the end of the week. So if price can break this level where the seller stepped in, we may be going to the upside. And since you're at a level of monthly support, I want to go into this trade and see if I can get a buy order. Let's go to the deal. All right, let's look at the trade that we took. Now I'm trying to go off memory, but again, I'm going to attach the trade to this video. I think I had a good indication that price wanted to go down a little bit, but I didn't think price was going to break this level. The reason why I didn't think price was going to break this level is because it's starting to make higher lows. look right here, guys. Yeah, price is going up and down. It's kind of like in a range right here, but it's not closing lower than back here. It's starting to make higher lows. So that tells me you have buyers in this area right here that's looking to push this price up higher. And that is the reason why I took the trade. Now, I didn't stay in the trade because I know it's a counter trend trade. So I didn't stay in the trade very long. I think I got like maybe 70 or 80 pips out of the trade. But I got in somewhere down here and I rode it up for like 70, 80 pips and then I closed out. Let me drag the trade onto the chart. Hold on 1 second. All right, guys, here's the actual trade. So you can see the levels. So here's the actual trade. So price came, went up, got right here. I took a buy order right here. Stop loss, take profit right here. Stop, take profit, buy order. Let's go down to a lower time frame. You can see it a little bit better. Go down to the 1 hour. This is the trade. Price went up when it pulled down into here. I went in, gave me a little bit of drawdown. My stop loss is back here. Went straight to the take profit though. That's 71 pips. And that's the trade on the Euro Swiss franc. I'm gonna attach the live trade so you guys can see it. But yeah, that's the advantage of, you know, taking trades off the daily time frame. And that's it, guys. New level, don't miss.